Hello and welcome to MechZone. Till the last lecture, we have discussed about the basics of radiation, and in the radiation chapter, we studied about different phenomena like transfer of heat that was taking place between the two infinite parallel plates. We also studied about the two concentric cylinders. Then we studied about the shape factor, view factor, or the configuration factor, and also studied about the related applications of those problems. We also discussed about that there were four laws actually. So there was Stefan Boltzmann law, there was Planck's law, there was Wien's displacement law, there was Kirchhoff's law, and we see that these laws are very important because questions sometimes are directly asked based upon only the formula. So today we will start discussing from the point irradiation and radiosity. Irradiation is denoted by the symbol G and radiosity is denoted by the symbol J. For example, we have a surface and we have certain amount of radiation which is striking this surface. This is actually the thermal radiation. Now, I already told you that radiation is the mode of heat transfer which is activated or which becomes significant only at very high temperatures. For example, when the temperature of the sun, we were discussing about the peripheral temperature of the sun, which was about 5300 or 5800 Kelvin, and there we had a large amount of radiations which are coming out corresponding to various wavelengths. Okay, now if I need to define G, that is irradiation, irradiation is defined as the total thermal radiation which is incident on a surface per unit time per unit area, per unit time and per unit area, per unit time per unit area. Okay, so whatever amount of radiation is striking the surface per unit time per unit area, that will be called as irradiation. Okay, now this surface will definitely have the property of reflecting this in radiation which is incident on this surface. Now the total amount of radiation energy which is leaving the surface per unit time per unit area, per unit time and area, the amount of energy which is leaving the surface per unit time per unit area, that is we will include reflected energy plus emitted energy, both the radiation which is reflected and the radiation which is emitted, this together is called as radiosity. Now one very small trick to remember the symbols J, radio, jockey. So radio is coming here and jockey is for J, so radiosity is for J and irradiation is for G. This is just a simply a small trick. Now whenever there is a surface and some thermal radiation is striking the surface, then some part of this radiation will be reflected. Some part of the radiation will be reflected and there will be some amount of emitted radiation from this surface. Okay, so if I write the energy balance, we will have J is equals to emitted energy plus reflected energy. Okay, so J is equals to emitted energy becomes E, E is the emissive power, plus reflected energy becomes rho into G. Rho is the reflectivity, G is the irradiation and J is the radiosity. So total amount of energy which is leaving is equal to the reflected energy plus the emitted energy. Okay, now we know that J is equals to E plus rho G, and we also know that epsilon is equals to E upon EB. Okay, so this E can be written as epsilon into EB. So I'm writing E as epsilon into EB plus. Now if we consider this surface, the surface that we have assumed here, if we consider this surface as an opaque surface, generally it is opaque. If we consider this surface as an opaque surface, then transmissivity of this opaque surface is zero. So we can write for this surface that alpha plus rho plus tau equals to 1, such that tau equals to 0, alpha plus rho equals to 1. Now we will apply the Kirchhoff's law, which states that the emissivity of a body is equal to its absorptivity. So instead of alpha, we will write epsilon plus rho equals to 1, or rho equals to 1 minus epsilon. So we will keep this value of rho here. Okay, so this becomes 1 minus epsilon into g. So this will become our new formula of radiosity. So total radiosity is equals to emissivity multiplied by the emissive power of a black body plus 1 minus emissivity into irradiation. Okay, this is the formula, and you have to remember it directly so as to solve the numericals. Okay, now if we consider two points, now I'm drawing the electrical analogy circuit such that I'm writing the Q net for the surface. Q net for the surface and surrounding. Q net for the surface and surrounding. If this point is EB and this point is J, then the resistance that will be encountered, the formula for resistance is 1 minus epsilon upon epsilon into A. This is the resistance. So if I write the equation for heat transfer, that will be EB minus J whole upon 1 minus epsilon into epsilon A. This is the resistance corresponding to the surface. Okay, this is the resistance which is corresponding to the surface, or this is also called as the surface resistance. So if a question is directly asked to evaluate the surface resistance, we will simply apply this formula, 1 minus epsilon upon epsilon into A. Now we will consider two plates which are infinitely large. This is first plate, this is second plate, this is 1, this is 2. Area is A1 and radiosity is J1. Okay, here we have area is A2, radiosity is J2. The radiations are leaving this surface 1 and reaching the surface 2, such that surface 2 is also giving out radiations. Now we have F12 and we have F21. F12 will be in this direction, F21 will be in this direction. F12 we have discussed, it is the view factor, and it states that the amount of energy which is leaving surface 1 and reaching the surface 2. Okay, now what we will do is we will try to write down the surface resistances and heat equation formula for this circuit. Okay, now Q net between 1 and 2 would be equals to J1 minus J2 into A1 F1 2. Okay, or Q12 net can be written as J1 minus J2 upon the resistance of this space would be 1 upon A1 F1 2. Okay, 1 upon A1 F1 2, where this is the actually the space resistance. This is the space resistance. The earlier was surface resistance, and this is the space resistance which is lying between these two infinitely long plates. Okay, now this resistance is existing between these two plates since there is a gap. Or if the gap is more the gap or the space existing between the smaller the shape, so the smaller the shape factor between them, it means higher is the space resistance. Jitna zyada aapka space rahega aur jitna chota shape or view factor rahega, utna hi zyada aapka space resistance hoga. Okay, agar if we draw a complete radiation network diagram complete radiation network diagram, then for this plate we will have the resistance, for this surface resistance would be 1 minus epsilon 1 upon A1 epsilon 1, such that the emissivity of the surface is epsilon 1. For the space we will have 1 upon A1 F1 2, and for this surface we will have the resistance as 1 minus epsilon 2, such that the emissivity is epsilon 2 upon A2 epsilon 2. This is the resistance of the surface corresponding to surface 1, this is the resistance of the space which is lying between them, and this is the resistance of the second plate or the second surface. So in total there are three resistances. Now if I wish to write Q12, I will write as sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 whole upon 1 minus epsilon 1 A1 epsilon 1 plus 1 upon A1 F1 2 plus 1 minus epsilon 2 A2 epsilon 2. This is the actual formula for the heat transfer between the two infinitely long parallel plates, including their space resistances and surface resistances. And you need to definitely remember this formula. And if I wish to write the space resistance only without considering the emissivity of these two bodies, then this formula will be obtained. Okay, now we will now study the applications of network method. Applications of network method. I hope my writing is visible to you all and it is quite understandable, because I write very fast, so it may be possible that sometimes you may not understand my writing. So you can comment in my channel that please अपनी राइटिंग अच्छी करें, बट ऐसा मुझे विश्वास है कि मेरी राइटिंग आप सबको समझ में जरूर आती होगी, और जो भी मैं आप लोगों को पढ़ाता हूँ आपको जरूर समझ में आता होगा. ओके, Now we will discuss about the applications of network method to two infinitely large plates. ये केस हमने पहले भी पढ़ चुके हैं. मान लीजिए ये जो हमारी प्लेट्स हैं बहुत लार्ज हैं, such that इसका एरिया A1 है, इसका एरिया A2 है, और हम ये मान के चल रहे हैं कि A1 is nearly equals to A2. ये अगर आपका सरफेस 1 है, ये सरफेस 2 है, so F12 बराबर F21 is equals to 1. ये दोनों ही आपके क्या है, 1, और ये एरिया मान लीजिए 1 मीटर स्क्वायर का एरिया है. तो Q12 नेट वुड बी द फॉर्मूला दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिराइव्ड अर्लियर, सिग्मा T1 टू द पावर ऑफ 4 माइनस T2 टू द पावर ऑफ 4 होल अपॉन 1 अपॉन एप्सिलॉन 1 प्लस 1 अपॉन एप्सिलॉन 2 माइनस 1, सच दैट द एमिसिविटी ऑफ द फर्स्ट सर्फेस इज एप्सिलॉन 1 एंड द एमिसिविटी ऑफ द सेकेंड सर्फेस इज एप्सिलॉन 2. Now similarly, if we discuss the case of concentric cylinders, if we consider the case of concentric cylinders also, for concentric cylinders also, and if we apply the network method, there also we will obtain the same formula for Qnet, that is sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 A1 whole upon 1 upon epsilon 1 plus A1 upon A2 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1. This formula will be obtained. Now we will study another important topic, that is radiation shields. We will study about radiation shields. So radiation shields are nothing but these are made of metals or metallic sheets like of copper or aluminium to reduce the radiation losses. For example, there is one sheet and there is another sheet such that it is at a temperature T1 Kelvin, it is at a temperature T2 Kelvin. The emissivity of this sheet is epsilon 1 and this one is epsilon 2. Now, if I wish to write down, the total emissive power would be EB1. Emissive power would be EB2. Okay, now if I wish to write down the circuit diagram, it would be this would be EB1, this would be EB2. This is for the first resistance, the resistance of this surface, that is 1 minus epsilon 1 A1 epsilon 1. Now in between them we have a space and the resistance of the space would be 1 upon A1F12. F12 is the view factor of first with respect to the second. This resistance is corresponding to the surface resistance of this body, that is 1 minus epsilon 2 upon A2 epsilon 2. Okay, now if I wish to write down Q net, I will simply obtain this formula, that is sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 whole upon 1 upon epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 minus 1. The reason is F12 is equals to 1 and A1 is equals to A2 is equals to 1. Okay, A1 is equals to 1 and A2 is also equals to 1. So this will be watts per meter square. Now, for example, if I introduce a metallic sheet in between these two bodies, such that its emissivity is epsilon 3, now we'll write the same circuit and we will try to derive the formula for Q net. You'll have this will be EB1, this will be EB2. The first resistance is corresponding to the surface, that is 1 minus epsilon 1 upon A1 epsilon 1. The second would be between space resistance between the surface 1 and 3, that would be 1 upon A1 F13. F13 is the view factor of 1 with respect to 3, that is amount of energy which is leaving the surface 1 and reaching the surface 3. Then again, what you will have? You will have the resistance of this third surface, that is 1 minus epsilon 3 upon A3 epsilon 3. A3 is the area of this plate, A1 is the area of this plate, and A2 is the area of this plate. Now we have reached EB3. This is EB3. Now from EB3 we will have the resistance of this surface, the resistance of the space, and then resistance of this surface. So we will write 1 minus epsilon 3 A3 epsilon 3 again. This resistance would be the resistance of the space, that is 1 upon A3 F32. F32 means the amount of energy which is leaving the surface 3 and reaching the surface 2. And then the resistance of this surface, that is 1 minus epsilon 2 A2. Okay, now if we consider A1 equals to A2 equals to A3 equals to 1 meter square, and we already know F13 is equals to 1, F32 is equals to 1. Okay, now by placing all these values in this equation and solving further, we will obtain the same formula that we have obtained in the previous case, that is Q net would be equals to sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 whole upon 1 upon epsilon 1 plus 1 upon epsilon 2 plus 2 upon epsilon 3 minus 2 watts per meter square. Okay, and we will observe that for this is shield is generally used for furnaces and cryogenic storages. It is used for furnaces and cryogenic storages. Cryogenics is actually the branch which mainly deals with maintaining very, very low temperatures, that is very low temperature refrigeration. And this epsilon 3, this emissivity should be low. Its emissivity should be low and reflectivity rho should be high. Please note down these properties. These are very important properties of this shield that is being introduced here, that its emissivity should be low and reflectivity should be high. Very high reflectivity and very low emissivity are the desirable properties of the radiation shield that is being introduced between the two metallic plates. Okay, now we will discuss a special case regarding to this previous phenomena, that is, we will discuss a special case regarding to this phenomena such that, say, no, this was not the paper. One second. Yeah. Corresponding to this case, that if epsilon 1, epsilon 2 and epsilon 3 all are equal, what will happen if the emissivity of the individual sheets or individual plates are equal to each other? Okay. Now, we will substitute epsilon 1 equals to epsilon 2 equals to epsilon 3 equals to epsilon. Now, if we place this substitution in this equation, we will obtain that Q is equals to sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 whole upon 2 upon epsilon minus 1. We obtain this formula. 2 upon epsilon minus 1, sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 upon 2 upon epsilon minus 1. This will be obtained. This is an important case because questions may be directly asked. So, in the special case, we saw that Q came out to be sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus T2 to the power of 4 whole upon 2 upon epsilon minus 1. So, this was the case that was obtained. Now, the questions are generally asked, for example, how many number of shields should be kept between the two infinitely parallel plates so as to reduce the heat radiation by certain percentage. Now, for that we have a formula, that is Q upon A with shield, Q upon A with shield is equals to 1 upon n plus 1 Q upon A without any shield, without shield. So Q upon A with shield is equals to Q upon A without shield. Now, if I place one shield between these two infinitely parallel plates such that n is equals to 1, then Q with upon Q without is equals to 1 upon 1 plus 1, because n is 1, we are placing just only one sheet. This will be 1 upon 2, so this becomes 50%. So by keeping just one sheet between the two infinitely parallel plates, the heat radiation losses will be reduced by 50%. Now if we place n is equals to 2 sheets, this ratio will come out to be 66.6%. For n is equals to 3 sheets, it will be 75%. You can calculate and verify. For n is equals to 4, we will have 80%. So this question that I have discussed right now, it was asked in GATE. And a large amount of data was given. Kahani puri bana kar di hui thi ki ye ho raha hai. Agar ek hi shield lagai to batai kitna percentage aapko reduction milega heat radiation mein. So ye tarika tha jisse humne us numerical ko solve kar liya. I hope aapko in sare lectures ke jo bhi basics maine aapko sikhaye hain wo sab aapko easily se samajh mein aa gaye honge. Ab aapko is pe related problems lagane hain. और जो भी आप प्रॉब्लम्स हैं, आप हमारे फेसबुक के पेज पर, फेसबुक पे पेज भी है हमारा मैगजोन, उस पर भी शेयर कर सकते हैं, या फिर आप चैनल पे भी कमेंट में अपना प्रॉब्लम डाल सकते हो, स्नैपशॉट लेके दे सकते हो प्रॉब्लम को, एंड वी विल ट्राई टू रिवर्ट बैक टू यू एज सून एज पॉसिबल. सो टुडे विद दिस वी कम टू द एंड ऑफ रेडिएशन. And I have explained you each and everything that is required to solve the problems of radiation. Now, in the next lecture, we will be starting with the last chapter of heat transfer, and that is convection. So thank you so much for watching the videos, and do subscribe to my channel, MechZone, and all the best for your examinations. Thank you.